I feel alone right now. This isn't what I thought my life would look like. It wasn't supposed to be like this. How did I even get here? If you're so good, why did it turn out so bad? It was my intention to do the right thing. But why? Why do I feel so disappointed? Why do I feel so discouraged? This isn't how I pictured my life. I had so many plans for the future. Everything made sense in my mind, God. Life was going fine until everything came to a stop. I'm searching for answers, but I don't know where to turn. I'm thinking about what tomorrow holds. I've tried everything I know, but I still feel the same. God, do you not think I'm trying? I'm not happy, God. Everything feels like a struggle. Is this what you had in mind when you created me? Where are you? Where are you, God, when I need you the most? You told me that you would never leave me or forsake me. But all I feel is alone. My reality is anxiety. All I do is worry. So I'm giving it up to you, God. I'm coming to you because I don't know what else to do. And I don't want to live my life this way.
I'm so glad you called my name. Your honesty draws me in. I love to hear from my children. I know you're hurting. I'm hurting for you. But you can rest in me now. Everything you're looking for is found in me. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I created you with great plans in mind. You can surrender your thoughts and frustration to me. I can handle them. What you're experiencing now, it won't last forever. None of this is a surprise to me. I knew you would arrive at this place. I'm so glad you chose to come to me. I've been waiting. I want to show you all that's in store for you. It may feel like the end, but it's just the beginning. The end of yourself is where I step in. My purpose is to transform you. I want to awaken my spirit in you. Your flesh will only get you so far. I never meant for you to do this life all by yourself. That's why I sent my son to restore you and show you the way. You had an idea of what life was, but I came to show you real life. My joy be your strength. Let me be your guide. My joy is not from this world. I want you to feel my freedom again. I want you to follow me. I want you to listen to me on this journey called life. You are my son and whom I want to protect. What you choose to do right now leads into what you will experience tomorrow. I will never leave you or forsake you because I love you.
All right, One Gen. Welcome, everyone. We're about to get started in a little bit. Just want to give you enough time to go ahead and get your popcorn, get your snacks, call a friend. If you haven't called a friend, go ahead and follow us also. Make sure you click on the link below. You know, One Gen LA. We're going to have a great time today. So I just want to welcome all of you guys before we get started. We have a message prepared for you. So make sure you stay for the message. We might play the message first because I know a lot of you guys tend to leave. So we might do a little bit different things today. All right. So we just want to welcome you. We're really excited. We're going to have a little kind of tricks up to our sleeves for you guys. I know I'm wearing sleeves, but it's just a thing to say. So yeah, go ahead and call your friends right now. We're going to get this thing started very, very soon. We're going to surprise you with some things. We have a video for you guys, another surprise. Powerful message from someone that I know very dearly, you know. So I'm just saying, get ready. Go get your friends. Go get your family members. Go get your mom. Go get your grandma. Go get your dog. Go get your cat. I don't care, but make sure they're all sitting in front right now. All right, guys? So we're going to get started right now, and welcome One Gen. Welcome One Gen. Awesome, right? You guys enjoyed it. I don't know if you've seen the video just yet, but I just want to let you know that a lot of the things that we do for you guys or will be doing for you guys in the near future is because we just want to, you know, keep you upbeat. We want to do things that are going to entertain you. I know we did the wing challenge a while back ago, but there's something that we always want to try to do for you guys. And don't forget, subscribe to YouTube. Put in the comments right now, hey, I want to see Pastor Alex do this. I want to see Edwin do that. You know, we're daring, so we might do it, you know. But we just wanted to give you a small word today. And I'm actually was given the privilege to come here today and give you that word. I know we've been talking in our small groups and also on our Sunday services. If you do remember, you know, we've been talking about faith, you know, and how sometimes we're facing situations in life, you know, that our faith is tested. But moving a little bit more forward on that subject, you know, it's also what do we find after our faith kicks in? And as the process is going in our lives, what is faith going to take us to? And today I just want to speak a little bit more about it and jump into a question of, are you at peace, right? Because a lot of times we're just like, okay, Edwin, you've been talking about going through struggles. And yeah, I go through my struggles and I'm going through situations. But what happens when God answers me? And is it the right answer? And I can guarantee you that when God speaks into your life it's going to be peaceful. And a lot of times, even as grownups, even as your parents are there right now, you know, they'll be asking themselves in situations, when am I going to find peace, or am I ever going to find peace, right? So, you know, some of these things is like, when do you really find great peace? And some people, if you ask them, find peace for a short while, right? Maybe you right now are sitting at home playing your PlayStation, your Xbox, and you're like, hey, when I'm in the zone, when I'm playing, you know, Call of Duty, when I'm over here doing whatever on the video game, I'm at peace. But someone comes in and interrupts it, and then all longer I'm in peace, right? Some of your parents might find peace when you guys aren't home, right? Right now that you guys have been home for a while, you might see that, you know, maybe your parents aren't really at peace. They're like, man, this kid's here every day, you know? But, you know, as many people continue to work towards that goal, try to work towards finding what makes them at peace, right? Because we can say a lot of times, you know, when we work so hard for that car, right? Because I know a lot of you guys are getting older now, and you guys are going to be 18 soon, and you're like, oh, when I'm 18, I'm going to be driving a Ferrari, I'm going to be driving a Porsche, I'm going to be driving a Range Rover, right? And that's a great goal. Maybe that puts you at peace, right? Some of you guys are like, oh, no, you know what? My peace of mind is when I get to college, you know, when I get to go to a school that I've been fighting for, right? Some of you just might be like, hey, I just want to graduate high school. I just want to graduate middle school, right? What is it that you're finding peace in is my question, right? And a lot of people start searching for peace in their lives as they start getting older, and sometimes they never find it. And it's crazy because I want to read a small passage in the Bible, Isaiah 26:3-4. So if you don't have your Bible, go ahead and get your Bible ready. Pull up that app. I know you guys have the app, so make sure you look at it. But a lot of times is many people spend their whole lives working for these physical things, but never find it. Because a lot of times people just tend to say, hey, you know what? If I had the nice car, you know, if I had the nice Camaro, if I had whatever car you like, and they get it, a lot of times after they get the car, they find that it's a bigger burden than it was before, right? They tend to find, hey, now I got to put insurance on it. I bet you know about insurance, but insurance is very costly, especially for a sports car or a nice luxury car, right? So I'm not saying, hey, you got to downgrade to a Toyota Prius, right? I'm not saying that. But I am telling you guys today that, you know, a lot of times when we try to find the physical things that we feel are going to give us peace, just give us more burdens, right? They give us more of a problem. You can ask people at church, some of your leaders that are older, they're like, hey, you know what? I'm paying like $600-$700 for a car that I don't know was supposed to be my dream car. And all of a sudden, it's not. Right. So people tend to keep finding trying to find peace in these physical things, but forget one thing, that the only one that can really give you peace of mind is God. See, a lot of times we're going to substitute that. We're going to substitute what we feel brings us peace. A lot of you guys getting older now. A lot of you guys will be probably, you know, once this whole quarantine is over, or maybe before even the quarantine started, you guys were already getting accustomed to, hey, my friend's going to throw a party at so-and-so house. Are you going to go? You know, or some of you guys may be influenced by other people that say, hey, why don't you try this? You know, we're talking about alcohol. We're talking about drugs. We're talking about stealing. We're talking about lying. A lot of times at your age right now, there's already people being influencing to your lives to bring you temporary peace, right? They say, hey, you're going through a tough situation. I went through the same thing. And then you're going to say, hey, why don't you just take this drink right here? It's going to put you at peace. See, I'm here to tell you that maybe in that moment, that consumption of a drug, of alcohol, or whatever it is, may put you for a few minutes at peace. But I guarantee you that that problem is not just going to go away by itself. I can guarantee you that if you don't look for God's presence, that problem is just going to become bigger and bigger. And not only will you continue to have that problem, but you're going to get into more problems because of the substances that you're trying to take. You're substituting what real peace is with other things. Right? And I just want to go in a little bit into the word. Isaiah 26:3-4. And I'm reading from the NIV version. And verse number 3 is a promise, okay? A promise that God is making for your life. And it says, verse 3 says, you will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are steadfast because they trust in you. See, right here, they're speaking about trusting in the Lord, trusting in God. A lot of us can see characters in the Bible that trusted in God. We have a King David that put all his trust in God when it came to defeating Goliath. When it came to saying everyone around him was scared. And all of a sudden David said, but I trust in the Lord and I'm going to pick up this rock and I'm going to swing it and it's going to hit that person and he's going to die. Now that's faith, but it's also trusting in God. Because our faith can be there. Our faith could actually be, okay, I have all the faith in the world, but do we really trust in God? See, the situations that you may be facing right now during this quarantine may be tough. Some of you guys might have been affected more than others, but where's your trust? You cannot have trust and only faith, and you can't only have faith without trust. See, God is telling you, if you want to find perfect peace, those whose minds are steadfast, those whose minds are secure, those whose minds know that God is everything, they will find that peace. At what cost are you ready to find real peace? Because a lot of you guys are going to graduate someday. A lot of you guys are going to turn 18 and probably stir away from home and say, hey, when I'm 18, I'm out of the house. I'm going to move out with my friends. I'm going to move to a different state. And if that's what God wants for your life, more power to you. But some of those decisions that you're probably making are out of anger or probably in a situation where you're just, I don't want to be here anymore. I'm gone when I'm 18. And what are you willing to risk if you don't have your mind set with faith in God? When you don't have that peace, that trust that God's going to give you, do you think you're going to leave home and everything is just going to be perfect? And you say, well, I moved out now. It's a new year. It's a new style of life for me. And everything's going to work out perfect. No, there's always going to be obstacles still in your life. See, we're trying to impart something into your lives today. Everything that we do, whether it's fun, you know, at the time, or whether, we may eat spicy food to make you laugh or whatever it is, but everything has a purpose behind it. It's to show you that God is the Almighty, that God has came into our lives. I can remember so many times in my life where I didn't trust in God. But I used to say and tell myself, I have faith in God. I know that God's going to get me out of the situation, but I should just to say it. See, there's a difference between just saying you have faith in God and actually trusting in God. Because when you don't trust in God, your mind is not at peace. The bills are going to, the situation is going to worsen. You know, if you're experiencing with drugs, you know, drugs are going to get worse. I've been there. It's not easy. I know what it's like to try to say, hey, I have faith because someone taught me faith, but not trust. I have trust issues. A lot of us will grow up and continue to have trust issues in people because of what they've done in the past. See, all these characters in the Bible, we talked about Moses. We talked about David. See, I'm not trying to compare you to them, but today I am telling you, you are in control. You could be a character in the Bible. See, the Bible speaks about certain characters that trusted in God, but I don't believe that, you know, we necessarily have to go based off of their trust in God. We have to learn to trust him on our own. We have to be able to learn to say, hey, Lord, what chapter in my life am I in right now? Because if someone was reading my story right now, They would read about the bad decisions I've made in life. They will read about the situations that I was in. But as they continue to read my story, they're going to say, but Edwin learned to trust in the Lord. That's the message we wanted to put to you today. How much is your trust in God? God is taking the personal responsibility for a true, genuine peace. So God is saying, hey, if you just trust in me, I promise you, I will give you peace. Verse 4 says, trust in the Lord forever. For the Lord himself is the rock, eternal peace. I don't know about you, but I know that you hear us talk about a rock and the palm trees. But I can guarantee you, when you're standing on that rock, that nothing will knock you down. And if it does, God's going to be right there next to you to uplift you again. There was a storm that the disciples were in, and Jesus was sleeping. But because the disciples forgot to trust in God, they had to wake up Jesus. They had to wake him up and say, hey, it's getting out of hand. See, I'd see that story, and many may say, man, why did they wake up Jesus? You know, he was trying to sleep. But I look at it like, when that storm does come, you seek God's presence. You seek Jesus, and he will tell you and restore you and say, hey, calm down. It's okay. I'm here. I'm in control. And I guarantee you, he appreciates that. He appreciates those moments when you're able to reach out to him, when you're able to go and say, Lord, I can't do this on my own anymore. I'm tired. I can't find inner peace. And when you do that, when it says, when you trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord himself is the rock of eternal peace. You had not been for God's presence. Where have you been? If it wasn't for God, I don't know where I would be today. But when I know that I put my trust in God, and he said, Edwin, I'm going to use you to be able to deliver messages to the youth, deliver messages of hope. Just put your trust in me. We're already ready to throw in the towel, and we stop putting our trust in God. But we need to learn how to accomplish this is by depending on God's power. Not the determinates, not the outcome of maybe the doctors telling you about a sickness that you may have and just saying, you know what, it's just over. God has the last word. I remember the other day I was seeing someone asking for prayer for their family member. And then there was someone that put something like, you know what, this, I know his intentions wasn't bad, but it was just saying, you know what, this is what the situation really looks like. It doesn't look good. And then one of my brothers in Christ that I love so dearly goes and says, you know what, I had the same situation or a situation similar to it. But we learned to trust in God. We learned to trust that God had the final answer. And the outcome was different. Don't give up. Don't let the doctors give you the final outcome. Let God be the one who says amen to your situation. Learn to trust in God's word. No matter what you may be going through, when you put your trust in God, he will keep his promise and give you peace. If you never had a problem, then we would never learn to look for his presence. Today, I just want to leave you with this. We need to learn to depend more on God's promises and his power for our lives. We cannot let other people come and give us a 2-3 second fix. We cannot allow people to come into our lives and lie to us and said, hey, do these things and you'll find peace. But the only one that could give you peace is God himself when you learn to trust in him. And I want to close it out with this. And I want to pray for you guys. And I want to pray for everyone out there that may be going through a hardship right now. That, Lord, Father, right now, you send your angels to protect them, Lord Jesus. For every petition, Lord Father, every person, Lord Father, that has been affected by the COVID-19, Lord. For those who have lost their jobs, Lord Father. For those whose health has been affected. For those who have family members, friends who have been affected. Right now, Lord Father, we call upon your name, Lord Father, to learn to trust you more. To be able to find that faith deep down inside of us, Lord Father. To be like David, Lord Father, and trust in you, Lord Jesus. Right now, Lord Father, we ask you to please protect our family members. We bless our ministry. We bless One Generation. We bless the youth pastors. We bless all the teams that were able to do these for you guys, to broadcast this for you, for the surprises we had for you. I just want to say thank you. We love you. We miss you. One Gen forever, and have a great day.
Hey, One Gen youth, this is what we're up to today. I want to show you our first victim, Edwin. He's gonna get, guess what hair? Put it in the chat, guess what hair? It's gonna be an amazing look on him.
I gotta be a victim though.
If I don't like it, he's cutting his hair.
How does it feel, Mom? Bleaching your own son's hair? Feel nervous?
Enjoy it.
Not yet.
How do you feel?
I feel like a crayon, bro.
No regrets.
All right, 3, 2, 1, go.
Hey. What you guys think? Let me know in the comments down below.
Once I get my taper, I'll be okay.
Yeah. Dude, yeah, bro. Cut did you good, bro?
Yeah, huh?
Ladies, watch out. I'm playing.
There you go. Talk to the cam.
One Gen, this is for you guys. Just want to let you know that we took it up a notch. If you want to top us, maybe we'll have Alex dye his eyebrows next. You know, I don't know.
Or we'll cut them based on what you guys said.
Wait, what? No.
Drop in the comments down below what you want us to do. Hope you enjoyed the youth service. We love you guys. Hope you enjoyed this segment. How's the wifey?
Don't have one now.
Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed that video. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to keep updates with One Gen LA. We love you. We hope you had a great laugh and a powerful, impacting word that you're going to take. Have a good one.